The Wasteland by T.S. Eliot. It is not easy to speak on the wasteland because 1922, the year the Wasteland was published, marks the beginning of a new era in English literature. It is a deciding date. And T.S. Eliot, who was basically an American, but in search of roots, he came to Britain and settled down in Britain and lived like a traditional Englishman. He was an intellectual giant, and he knew Greek literature, he knew Latin, he knew much of French literature, he knew much of Indian literature, the Vedas and the Upanishads, and he of course knew Bible and the English literature and American literature. So he was, and he was a Puritan at heart. He was very knowledgeable, and he was a Puritan at heart, and he was not satisfied with the way modern civilization is going. The Wasteland is a very, you can say that it is an adult kind of a poem, and it is an epic, abridged epic it is called, written in poetic shorthand. It is not very long, but the references are so dense that if you go into each reference, it will form a huge epic. So he was not happy with the moral degeneration of the modern world. He felt that things are mechanized, that relationships are soulless, and that human society is certainly not moving in the direction of dharma, in the direction of goodness, in the direction of righteousness. That was his perception. So when human direction itself is wrong, we will reach, where we will reach? We will reach the wasteland, the barren land, the land where nothing grows, the land which signifies the wrath of God. That is the concept of the wasteland. What is poetic shorthand? Poetic shorthand is that he has taken, say, in one line or in two lines or in three lines, he has taken a reference from Bible, a reference from Vedas, one reference from a ballet, and one reference from English literature, and combined them and created a poetic mosaic, combined them in a meaningful manner to convey the meaning. To convey the meaning in a very pungent, in a very bitter, in a very powerful, and in a very straightforward manner. That, for example, 9 o'clock, everybody is rushing to the office. The whole humanity is rushing, London Bridge, everybody is rushing to the office mechanically. Nobody remembers, and they cross a church. Nobody remembers that it was 9 o'clock that Christ was crucified. That man was put on a cross, and nails were stuck in his body for the sake of love, for the sake of fraternity, for the sake of trust. He died, he was crucified. Nobody remembers that. It's a mechanical hour for the whole of this humanity. Man has forgotten, human race has forgotten its spiritual roots. there is this two ladies sitting in a cafe, and they're all the concepts of beauty, the concepts of relationship, everything is so immoral, so very superficial, that it is a meeting of matter. It is just a meeting of material. There is no meeting of souls. There is no spirituality in it. There is no commitment in it. There is no religious sanction in it. And all, you see, there is this knock-knock. That knock-knock in the cafe is the divine force knocking at humanity. The divine force is knocking at humanity, trying to bring humanity back to the path of goodness. There is this sailor, and the sailor has come to land for some months, and one friend is telling the other that go and please him, and otherwise you will find somebody else. It is like a trade. There is an intimate scene, and the heart is pumping like a machine. The heart is pumping like a machine, just like a machine. So T.S. Eliot is totally frustrated by the barrenness of human mind. And this is what is portrayed. It is the wrath of God. The Hyacinth girl, the Grail, the Holy Grail legend, Tiresias, all these legends run parallel, one after another. And again and again, that by the sea there is a party, and there is no satisfaction at the end. There is no fulfillment at the end. Why it is so? This question has been raised in the wasteland. So he has created a poetic mosaic of different references. You have to get into it. Nobody can teach the wasteland. I can only show you the path. Anybody can show you the style, how to go about it, how to go about references. But you have to get into it. You have to get into the soul of the text and understand what T.S. Eliot has tried to convey. That there is a burning rock. That burning rock signifies again the wrath of God. That humanity has brought itself to the brink of destruction, you can say. That is portrayed in this poem, divided into five parts. And finally, T.S. Eliot comes and gives a solution. He comes to a solution from Brihadaranyaka Upanishad. Daan, Daya, Daman. That the Upanishad, the path of Upanishad will save humanity. Daan, let go. Don't assimilate more than you require. Give away without any reason. Daan, Daya, kindness. Nothing is to be held back. Forgive a person, evil, devil, angel, good, bad. Forgive, daya, kindness, and daman, that urges, physical urges, material urges, have to be kept somewhere. They have to be closed somewhere. A person, a human being, must try to rise above them. Daman, daan, daya, daman. Then that is the final solution, that is the culmination of the whole of this masterpiece. And it is difficult to describe the importance of the wasteland in modern English literature. T.S. Eliot led to the Nobel Prize, of course. And T.S. Eliot is T.S. Eliot. Everybody knows his contribution. But The Wasteland expresses his anguish with the modern human being to the deepest, to the maximum. And the range of his knowledge is mind-boggling. You do not know where it ends. One word has four references. One single word has four or five references. So you have to go into that, because every reference has a meaning. And he will drive home. He will drive home the barrenness, the dryness, the ugliness of mechanical friendship, mechanical association. He's a Puritan. मुझको मतलब मुझे लगता है जैसे मिल्टन की आत्मा उसमें बैठी हुई थी या क्या था, I don't know. But somehow he's a Puritan at heart. His poetry is called symbolical because he has gathered so many references, and he can talk only symbolically. He cannot describe everything in detail, otherwise it would have taken four lives. He would not have completed the poem. So he talks symbolically only, and the range of his knowledge and the depth of his knowledge is for there everyone to see, for the, it is for there to see. The point is that when we read The Wasteland, we have to get into the spirit of it. It scares you. It certainly scares you, because he is talking about consequences. He is talking about the consequences of moral degradation. Nothing less. It cannot be camouflaged. It cannot be hidden. This is a poem directly about human instincts, human impulses. It is about associations and friendship and relationships. And it is about following religion. It is about following the correct path. And if the correct path is not followed, what would be the consequences? And what is the remedy? As I told you, finally he comes to Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, and there he ends the poem. So it's a when I was in MA, I must have studied this poem the whole year. I studied it so many times, I never knew how many times, because every time I read it, a new meaning came. A new reference came, some new insight came. So you have to get into this poem, and to understand The Wasteland is in itself an achievement. So good luck to you, students. Go ahead.